Dear friends, this is Jiří Dufek on the Racha channel, and today I will show you a very interesting way how to play with black delayed Benoni variation with new ideas, which was found by former Yugoslavian players Ivanišević, and which was tried to Aharonian too in his following games. Let's start. D4. Knight f6, c4, c5, d5, g6. Let's move some moves in the opening. Knight c3, bishop g7, e4, short castle, bishop d3, d6, h3, e6, knight f3. Which is basic position of our investigation in this line. And now Ivanišević in this game against Leon Aronian in Tromsø 2014 found very interesting, relatively new move, knight bd7, with very deep idea. Short castle. And now, not to play any ed5 moves to transpose to classical Benoni after cd, or to some slightly unpleasant position after ed5. Because after ed, we see that this with this open file, it's a very big problem to find any counterplay with black, and in this position, black is simply worse. But he played e5 to transpose to some strange King's Indian defense, because usually this pawn structure is not very good for black, because it's very hard to make counterplay, because there is no counterplay on queen side, because b5 square is covered. And in fact, it's not so simple to play f5, because this diagonal is controlled by white pieces, and maybe e6 square can be weak after something like knight g5 and knight e6. That is why Levon played bishop g5 with the old idea by Petersen, simply forced to black to play a6, and then use the fact that this pawn can be weak, and playing f5 can be problematic, because there are some ideas with move knight h4 with attacking g6 and h5. But Ivanišević played h6, bishop d2, with interesting idea queen c1 to make a battery on this pawn, and after h7 to move queen c2, and then we see that with king on h7, this battery of this diagonal is very unpleasant, and it's, in fact, it's not easy to play move f5. But black played knight h7, which looks absolutely senseless, because after queen c1, there is no simple way to defend this pawn. And we will think about how to defend this pawn. There are just only two moves. Terrible g5 move, which means that all white squares, mainly f5, is covered by white pieces, and there is not any f5 ideas for black. Or to play h5. But even after that, it's not so easy to make any progress, because one on h5 will be quite weak. And in fact, black pawn structure loses its elasticity. But black has absolutely amazing idea on his mind. And he simply sacrificed his pawn. He played f5. Now, more or less all moves are forced. Of course, white could take on f5, and after gf, bishop takes h6, queen f6, bishop g7, queen g7. He can took at this pawn, but as minimum, black has a very nice hegemon compensation in this position. There are some ideas, h8, rook g8, and f6, maybe bishop d7, then rook to f8, and then he can think about f4 or e4 to start drawing his pawns. Things are not so simple because, for example, thinking about very quick e4 in this position can be very terrible, because after e4, there I can simply sacrifice a piece on e4 with the three pawns for a piece and with very strong attack. But Levon thought that probably taking on h6 cannot be a bad move. After f4, bishop g7, king g7, bishop e2, it looks like white is simply one up with no real counterplay, and still white can block a king's side with something like knight h2, f3, or bishop g4. But black played knight df6, a3, starting counterplay on queen side. Probably after something like knight h2, it's very sensible to play knight g5. And now, but can start to think about sacrificing on h3. And after f3, rook h8, white position is quite dangerous. a3, bishop d7, rook d1, mainly thinking about escaping his king at some moment. g5, of course, idea playing g4 is very dangerous. And now Levon played g4, which is interesting. After knight h2, with controlling this square, doesn't automatically mean that stopping a g4 move, because even after that, black would play g4 with some exchanging of pieces on g4 and knight g5 and took h8 with very strong attack. Probably the same idea after king f1, g4 with attack. But after g4, it looks like white is absolutely okay. King side is blocked and there is no any real counterplay, and even black has some problems with this pawn, because it's not so easy to entangle this knight. But things are absolutely amazing. Rook h8, rook d3, now black played knight f8. He simply sacrificed this pawn, and in fact, at this moment, the pawn cannot be taken, because after knight g5, black can play knight g4, knight e6 checks, bishop takes e6, d e, knight f6 back, queen d1, knight takes e6, rook d6, queen e7, and we see that knight d4 is a very unpleasant threat, rook h3 is very unpleasant, and of course second rook on open g file. And white is in very big danger. That is why Levon played queen f1 to just defend this pawn. And with, of course, still idea g5 is hanging, then black must to defend this pawn, but he didn't defend it. He simply played Queen G, knight G6. Knight takes g5. And very strong. Knight h7. Leon took. Probably he saw that after knight f3 there is knight h4. That is why he took on h7. Rook takes h7. Queen g2. Queen g5. And Black can continue with his attack on kingside. He wants simply double on h4 and using the very weak h4 square for probably his knight. And maybe there are some ideas with f3. That is why now White played f3 alone. f3, rook h8, bishop f1, and Black simply improved his position with rook h6. Probably after taking on h3, queen takes, rook takes, bishop takes, queen h4, bishop g2, and now to transfer the knight over h8 square to g5. Probably position is close to equal because there is just only few pieces. And Black probably cannot use a fuck of very strong grip on Black squares. Now after rook h6, rook c1, rook h7, rook c2, queen d8, with some ideas, probably queen h8, but even after queen h2, another very strong move, knight h8. To transfer to knight, this knight to g5 square. That position is quite slow. And Black can simply improve his position move by move. It's quite sad that after queen h1, knight f7, rook h2, knight g5, rook dd2, both players agreed on a draw, which is quite sad finish of this game. Because Black is simply better. He can improve still his position with moves like rook h4, h6, b5, queen a5 to open the queen side, and use the fact that white pieces are absolutely passive with no counterplay on king side, and Black is simply better in this position. Computer gives a very big advantage, I think, 1.5 pawn for white, which is much more important and interesting. That few years ago, after this game, even Levon Aronian took this idea. And in Blitz game on chess.com against Anish Giri, in this position he include a6, a4, but played with the same manner. Knight bd7, short castle, e5, bishop g5, h6, bishop e3, knight h7, queen d2, f5, bishop h6, f4, bishop g7, king g7. We see the difference between Aronian Ivanišević and this game. It's just in two pawns, and with this queen, which is on d2 and not on c1. But this is just a cosmetical difference. After knight h2, knight df6, bishop e2, rook h8, f3 knight g5, we see the same setup with the black as in the main game. And after knight g4, Levon finished game in a style with knight takes h3, g takes, rook takes, rook f2, and after rook takes g4, fg, queen h4, Anish resign. Which is not surprising because he will just deliver mate. But still, the main point and another point of this setup is that Levon tried this with the white pieces. And this is, I think, a very good sign that he loves this idea. He played this game against Yilmaz in Batumi 2018, And he played c4, e6, g3, d5. Bishop g2, knight f6, knight f3, d4, short castle c5, d3, knight c6, e3, bishop b6. We saw very similar pawn structure. In fact, it will be the same in a few moves. a3, a5, knight bd2, short castle, e4, e5. Same pawn structure with a small difference, the personal a6. And black lost two moves with his e-pawn. But after h3, bishop d7, knight h2, queen c8, f4. Yeah, Levon Aronen used the same attacking setup. Bishop takes h3, f5, bishop g2, king g2, rook e8, g4, e6. Knight df3, king f8, g5. After hg, bishop g5, he had a very strong attack. And even if the position or game finished in a draw in another 12 moves, I think that he got a very nice position at this moment. I think that the whole idea with this setup, which can arise, for example, from English or Red opening, or from this delayed Benoni, the idea to play after this battery, queen c1, to play f5, and simply sacrifice this pawn on h6 and get an attack on the king side with some crushing ideas against h3 pawn are very interesting and can surprise your opponent in a very early stage of a game. Thank you for watching and see you next time. Bye bye.